Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to perform sorting and filtering in the .NET MAUI ListView control. You'll see programmatic sorting, custom sorting, and sorting items along with grouping. You'll also learn how to filter items programmatically, clear filtering, and sort filtered items. Finally, you will see how to customize the empty view when the list view has no items. I'm using the example application that includes the necessary namespace and added MAUI ListView control with data. You can watch the Getting Started video I've shared in the YouTube card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the list view displays all the book's data in unsorted order. First, let's see how to sort items programmatically. For that, add the Syncfusion MAUI data source namespace. Then, define the data source with the sort descriptors property in the list view. To sort items based on book name, add sort descriptor. And set its property name to book name. And the direction to ascending. Notice that all the book items are displaying in ascending order. Next, I will show you how to sort items based on custom logic. For example, if we want to sort the books based on the length of their titles. First, create a new converter class named CustomSortComparer. That inherits the iComparer interface with the compare method. In this method, check that the object type is bookInfo. If it is, create two fields, xItem and yItem, to get the book titles. Now, add custom sorting logic to sort the book titles based on their length. Next, go to the main page XAML. Add this comparer class to the page resources. And set its key to custom sort comparer. Then, remove the property name and direction properties in the sort descriptor. After that, define the comparer property and set its value to the resource key custom sort comparer. You can see that all the book items are arranged based on the title length. Next, let's see how to sort items with grouping. To group the header, first add the group header template. And define a data template for it. Inside this template, add a label and bind its text to the key. To customize the label, I define these properties with an appropriate value. To sort book items in ascending order, remove the comparer in sort descriptor. Then set the property name to book name. And the direction to ascending. Next, go to the XAML CS file. To group data, create a new group descriptor. Set its property name to book name. And get its key selector as the first letter in the book title. Then, add it to the datasource group descriptors property. You can see the book items are grouped and arranged in ascending order. Okay, I need to revert the sorting code changes for filtering. Now I'll show you how to filter items programmatically. I can search the items by adding the search bar in the XAML page and set its name to filter text. Also define the height and placeholder properties to customize it. the list view items will be filtered by setting the datasource filter. To set that, define text changed event with appropriate event handler. Next, go to the XAML CS file. Create a new field named search bar and get its value in the text changed event handler method. Now, create a new method called filterBooks. Inside this method, check whether the search bar or search bar text is null. If it is, it returns true. After this, create a new field to get book information. Now, we check the condition, whether any property's value of book info contains the search bar text. If it does, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. Now, move to the search bar text changed event handler method. First, check the data source is not equal to null. Then define the data source filter and set its value to the filter books method. Next, to refresh view, add the datasource refresh filter method. Once loaded, we can search for items. You can see that the list view displays only the filtered items. Next, I will show you how to clear the filtered items. Go to the XAML page. Add a new button with its clicked event. Then, move to this button clicked event. Set the datasource filter to null. And call the datasource refresh filter method. Once loaded, search for items in the search bar. After the filtering, we can click on the clear button. Notice here, the searched items are cleared even though the search bar has text, and the list view shows all the items. To sort the filter items, we need to define the datasource filter changed event in the constructor. In this event handler method, first call the datasource sort descriptors clear method. After this, create a new sort descriptor and set its property name to book name and its direction to ascending. Then, add it to the datasource sort descriptors property. Finally, call the refresh view method to update the list view items. When searching for items in the search bar, you can see the filtered items are sorted in ascending order. Now, clearing the text in the search bar, you can see that list view displays all the items in ascending order. If you want to display items in their original order, then go to the filter text changed method and check if the filter text is null or empty. If it is either, clear the datasource sort descriptors and call the refresh view method. Search for items in the search bar. Notice here that the items are filtered. Now, clearing the text in the search bar, you can see the items are displaying in the original order. Next, I will show you how to display and customize the empty view when the list view has no items. I search for Java in the list view. Notice here, the Java is not found in the list and an empty view is displayed. You can display a string, view, and custom template in the empty view. If you want to display a text in the empty view, go to the List View control. Then define the empty view property and set its value to no items. Once the list view is loaded, search for Java in the list. You will see the given string displayed in the empty view. To learn more about the empty view customization, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description. In this video, I have shown you how to perform sorting and filtering in the .NET MAUI ListView control and their related operations. I also showed you how to customize the empty view. If you want to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.